If you have your Bibles, please turn to James 1, 2 through 4. James 1, 2 through 4. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. Have you ever been in a situation that has been full of stress, negativity, and tribulation? Have you ever found yourself doubting or facing trials that has tested your faith? Tonight, we will look at overcoming past failures and how to persevere through trials by growing spiritually, gaining patience, and trusting the Lord. First, we will look at spiritual growth. If you would, turn to Proverbs 3, 11 and 12. My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor detest his correction. For whom the Lord loves, he corrects, just as a father the son in whom he delights. By allowing the Lord to chasten and correct us, we grow closer to him and stronger in our faith. Paul, formerly known as Saul, is an amazing example of spiritual growth. Once a persecutor of Christians and a strong force against the church, he became a strong fighter for Christ. He endured many trials, 2 Corinthians 11, verse 23 through 28. Are they ministers of Christ? I speak as a fool. I am more. And labors more abundant in stripes above measure, and prisons more frequently, and thus often. From the Jews, 5 times I received 40 stripes minus 1. 3 times I was beaten with rods, once I was stoned. 3 times I was shipwrecked, a night and a day I have been in the deep. In journeys often, in perils of water, in perils of robbers, in perils of my own countrymen, in perils of the Gentiles, in perils of in the city, in perils in the wilderness, in perils in the sea, in perils among false brethren, in weariness and toil, and sleeplessness often, and hunger and thirst, and fastings often, and cold and nakedness, besides the other things, what comes upon me daily, my deep concern for all of the churches. When we feel as though we have faced too many problems and our faith has grown weak, we must remember the growth and strength of Paul. Secondly, patience. Galatians 5, 22 and 23 says that, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. Long-suffering with others and ourselves is immensely important. Without patience, we cannot endure the trials that we face. When we have patience through the problems that we face head-on, we will grow even more abundantly in the Lord. Lastly, we must put our trust in the Lord, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. When we trust in the Lord completely and absolutely, he will direct our paths. The Lord is our rock and a stronghold for our trust. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Hebrews 13, 5. When we face the various inevitable problems of life, we must learn to grow, have patience, and trust in the Lord. When we build on these things, we will become positive and effective leaders for ourselves and for others. Let us all remember to watch, stand fast in the faith, be brave, and be strong. 1 Corinthians 16, verse 13.